Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to St. Mary's Perivale. It's Thursday and time for some chamber music. Got a particularly lovely programme for you this afternoon. You can read about it on the website and all the bios and everything, but it's three wonderful musicians: Anna Hashimoto on clarinet, Megan Cassidy on viola, and Florian Mitria on piano. And they're playing Brahms' clarinet sonata, followed by Schumann's Fantasiestücke for viola and piano, and then ending up with Mozart's fabulous Kegelstadt Trio for clarinet, viola and piano, a gem of the chamber music repertoire. And the musicians are going to tell you odds and ends about the pieces as we go along. But it's gorgeous music all afternoon and very varied, and three wonderful musicians. So time to kick off, and I'll get off the stage and we'll start off with Anna and Florian playing the Brahms F minor clarinet sonata. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Anna, the clarinetist of the group. And yes, we're really happy to be here for today's live stream. It feels like a really significant way to mark approximately a year since we first went into lockdown. And what a great thing to continue to do and have live music in this way as well. I'm particularly happy to be bringing such wonderful, the best pieces that we just want to play to really enjoy the best of chamber music, and also to be playing with some fantastic colleagues. I actually met Megan, our violist, at secondary school, so it's been, I've known you more than half my life. And then Florian, we met at the Royal Academy of Music, and I was just telling Hugh that we actually first met at the Academy marking theory papers for ABRSM. So, yep, funny, all these things. Anyway, we're going to start with the Brahms Sonata in F minor. All of Brahms's clarinet works were written towards the end of his life when he had already decided to retire, but after listening to the wonderful clarinetist Mühlfeld, he was inspired to write these wonderful works. So he wrote the two sonatas, trio and quintet, and yes, it's one of our favourite pieces. We were just saying the last time that Florian and I played this was at the Lucerne Festival in Switzerland, and we had spent the day eating lots of chocolate. We haven't done this time, but one day we hope to eat lots of chocolate again. And without further ado, this is the Brahms.
Wow, that was beautiful. Thank you, Anna and Florian, for that wonderful, wonderful Brahms. It's always been a privilege to perform and listen to chamber music, and even more so now. So a huge thank you to Hugh for organising for this year. This whole year has been tremendous here at St Mary's. And also lovely Andrew, who's been in charge of the sound and the video, for doing such a great job. It's really remarkable. So Florian and I are now going to play you some Schumann, the Fantasy Stücke. So this was composed in 1849. And as Schumann was such a genius, it was one of those things that he wrote it down in 2 days. So that's basically from brain to paper, isn't it? There's no mistakes there. The only mistake he made was he originally called it a salon piece, and then he decided to change it. So that's quite wonderful. I hope that in my life, those are the only mistakes that I make, is just deciding to change the title of something. So I hope you enjoy it.
think I'll say a few words and I'll say hello as well while the girls are getting ready. It really is truly wonderful. It is more than a year since I've played music with other people on stage, and I've missed it very, very dearly. And it is lovely to be with, not just with any musicians, but with these lovely, lovely ladies, and to make this wonderful music. And we're probably going to end up with the most famous piece for this formation. And I think I drew the lots to talk about Mozart. And I still haven't given up on my challenge to convince you that we need a Mozart festival as well. But you know how obsessed I am with the composer. And this piece, it just shows that even when he wanted to have fun, he was still genius. So Kegelstadt, because I speak -2 German, basically, I always thought that it must be the name of a sponsor or something meaningful, you know, like the Waldstein, the sonata is called the Waldstein Sonata because it was dedicated to Count Waldstein, or something, you know, groundbreaking like that. And it turns out it's the German name for a game that resembles bowling, or skittles, I think it's also called. It's a 9-pin skittles, which I understand can be played outside as well as inside. And it involves you rolling a wooden ball and sort of knocking down the wooden pins or whatever there were. And Mozart liked it very much. And I'm reliably informed that the rhythmic formula, rhythmic motif of the first movement is basically a musical illustration of the pam prarara, when the ball goes and sort of rattles along the bowling alley and sort of knocks the pins down. So it's supposed to be a fun piece. But then you get the minuet, which I think is one of the most extraordinary Mozarts ever. I mean, the modulations are absolutely bonkers. I mean, it's so ahead of his time. And so, I mean, it's crazy. And we're sort of pulled left, right, and center. And the rhythm gets all over the place. And the strong beat gets displaced. It's not your bog standard minuet and trio, because he had to do it. It really is an absolutely genius piece, unique in all respects. And I think the combination is unique, but we know that he loved the viola more than the cello. But don't tell anyone. He loved the viola. He played a viola. And the viola part here is just, it's juicy. It's wonderful. It really brings that wonderful color to the sound. And everyone together, it really is chamber music. I think there's no, it's almost polyphonic the way it's written, when nobody's accompanying anyone at any time. There's always a very valuable contribution. I suppose just like Salieri says in the film, you take one note away and it just falls apart. It's so perfectly constructed. So we it was an absolute pleasure to be with you, to play for you this afternoon. And I very much hope that you enjoy the last piece. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that was such a joyous concert, as someone was saying on the live chat. It makes up for COVID and everything. Just immortal music, life-enhancing, played wonderfully well by three wonderful musicians who are always welcome back here. Just doesn't get any better than that. I hope it's cheered your afternoon wherever you are. And if it has, you might like to go along to our donations page and put something in to pay all these wonderful musicians. They all get paid, and it keeps the show on the road. On Sunday, we have a special lecture by Vanessa Latarche, who's in charge of keyboard at the Royal College of Music, talking about guiding young talents. It should be absolutely fascinating. Next week, we have a piano recital on Tuesday, Matthew McLachlan. And then, actually, we've got a rather similar concert a week today with Anna, Bob, and Hugh. That's how they style themselves. A flute, viola, and harp combination. So for once, we'll put the piano away. They're all very good players, and it should be absolutely fascinating and wonderful. Thank you very much for being with us. Tell your friends. Please keep donating. And thank you very much for all your support. It's sustaining all these wonderful musicians and keeping me sane over these long months. Thank you very much and good afternoon.